pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Madam Clerk, do I have a roll call, please?
Alderman Bowman.
Present.
Alderman Donovan.
Present.
Alderman Milner.
Present.
Alderman Coburn.
Here.
Alderman Dickerson.
Here.
Alderman Long.
Here.
Alderman Stoll.
Here.
Alderman Stafford.
Here.
Mayor Hasty.
Here. We do have a forum. Good evening, everyone. Tonight, we do have some ceremonial matters. Couple of service awards to give tonight. The first is for Steve Woodring. Good evening, sir.
Evening.
Steve has been with us for 30 years now, which is quite a milestone to reach, I believe, in any profession. So we appreciate you giving us 30 years and hope you stick around a little while longer.
I'll be here for a little bit.
Well, that would be great. That would be great. So, well, congratulations.
All right. Everyone kind of turn toward me, please. Nice smile. And one more time, nice smile. Thank you so much.
All right. Lee Darling has been with us for 15 years. Lee, how are you doing?
Good, how are you doing?
Oh, very good, very good. So you're halfway there.
Yes,
you're halfway there. So again, we hope to have you for another 15.
I could have been there all the way, but I quit for 15 years and then came back.
Oh, did you? Oh, well. Well, see, now if you work another 15, then you can do this all over again.
Yeah, so I'm gonna try.
All right. Well, congratulations. We appreciate your 15 years.
All right. Here we go. And one more time. Thank you.
At this time, I'll open the floor for public participation. Anybody who has anything to bring before this board that is not already on our agenda, please step forward. Be sure to give the clerk your name and address, please. Good evening, John.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor and Council. I wanted to mention two or three things that concerns me about our city. One of them is we've had two older businesses announced in the last few days that they're abandoning. The Allen Bank is abandoning the building. That's been a bank there since 1868. William Allen was the one that organized that, and we all understand that all businesses, in order to be profitable, have to reset. And my question is, do we have an ordinance in effect to get signage removed off of buildings that has been abandoned? And do we have, does the fire chief inspect those buildings for clutter? I wonder about lots of times buildings are abandoned and boxes of paperwork is just left in place, and it's not a safe thing for us. The other thing that I know you're aware of, in 1869, the Democrat Herald was formed, which we now know as the Democrat Missourian. That office is no longer open, and I wonder about the signage on that building, and I also wonder about the clutter that's in those buildings. Now, they also own the building that used to be known as Harrisonville Glass down on Mechanic Street. And that has been abandoned for several months or years. We have several commercial buildings that have been abandoned in the town that is definite eyesores, and some of them haven't been occupied for 30 years. And I don't know whether we have ordinances in place for the property owners to improve them or to demolish them. The building that was built in 1953 by Dr. John Anderson over on Wall Street, why, his granddaughters had that removed. And if you haven't been by there, that is the way we should tidy up the town. We have taken down five houses in the last 15 months, and we put up four. So we need to look at a way of tidying up some things. The old motel on South Independence and Mechanic Street, not Mechanic, Commercial Street, has sat there empty for a decade or more. We've got buildings everywhere that's been abandoned, needs paint, needs, the grounds need to be maintained, and anyhow, my question is, have we got ordinance in effect that we can let our city employees put into effect and kind of get our town cleaned up? We are going to have visitors when all of these fueling centers open up, and we've got something to show, but we need to get rid of the clutter. I thank you. Any questions of me?
I would assume we don't have the answer tonight, but we will.
I appreciate that.
We'll definitely look at that. You bet.
John, what's the deal on this Commerce Bank down here, where this bank was down here by the post office? Is it?
Next door.
Yeah, next door to the post office. What's the deal on that?
The BC Bank, and next door to the post office, I talked to that real estate agent last week. There has been a contract offered on that, but the owner has refused to sign the contract. And she would like to have a backup contract. And if anybody knows anybody that's looking for a well-built Foster building, why, there's one available.
That wasn't a plug or anything, was it?
No, sir.
Okay. Yeah, did you have a comment?
Well, I was curious if you could tell me, I know originally that was a bank, and I don't know if you know or not, but I was told at one point that there was a something written, and I don't know if it was the ownership paperwork or what, that essentially, since it was a bank, you cannot put a bank back in there.
The agent, I visited that agent on that, and that is correct. The sale on that was going to be titled, no bank back into it. But I was told that the owner has wavered that, and if somebody wants to put a bank in there, they can.
Thank you.
Thank you, John. Anyone else would like to address the board this evening? Seeing no one, I will close public participation at this time and move on to the approval of the minutes from the January 18th.
If we approve the minutes as written.
Motion from Alderman Coburn.
Second.
Second from Alderman Milner. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Minutes are approved. Moving on to Council Bill 013.
Council Bill 013, a resolution to authorize the city administrator to sign the attached certification form required by the Environmental Protection Agency.
This is a ministerial function, basically. We're required to do this as part of our application for SRF funding for the water plant improvement project. It means that we can't use these funds to lobby with, which we haven't done, we don't do. But it's just something, it's part of the package that we have to submit. So the board needs to go on record supporting it.
Discussion on this item. And I entertain a motion to approve.
Move to approve it as approved.
Second.
I have a motion from Alderman Coburn and a second from Alderman Dahlman. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Council Bill 013 becomes part of Resolution R009. Council Bill 014.
A resolution authorizing the city administrator to execute an agreement with KB Maintenance Supply for the purchase of one Craco SS125. Milner applicator for the street department in an amount not to exceed $33,972.
Good evening, Rodney.
Good evening, Mayor, members of the board. I've come to you before you to ask you to approve this purchase. We like to call it this crack sealer. Okay. It's just a big pot that heats up the rubberized sealant and we apply it to cracks. The one we have looks good, but it's worn out.
And that's an important piece of equipment, if I understand.
Well, we'd like to use it. We'd like to use the more we have, but time, you know, we have only have so much time. So having having one with us When we have that time, we can just use it. If not, we have to get in line, we rent one, and the cost of renting one is extremely expensive. If you have any questions, I'd be glad to answer.
Was this a budgeted item?
Yes, it was a budget.
Okay.
And I noticed you brought it in for $28 less than the budget.
Yeah, actually, I forgot to add a heater to it.
A heater?
What the heater does right now, when we want to use this machine, the operating temperature, the oil is not 500 degrees, and we have to go from zero to 500 degrees. And then we have to let that, it acts like a double boiler, and then it heats the sealant inside, which is rubberized stuff, to keep that from catching fire. And if we, with the heater, which is just basically a block, like a block heater on a cone, it heats oil up, and so you just plug in instead of having a direct fire on it. And so it gets you a head start. So I hope to get that on it for some other meetings. So, because I do think it's important, I just neglect to put that on. So.
Understood.
I entertain a motion to approve.
I make a motion to approve.
Second.
I have a motion from Alderman Dickerson and a second from Alderman Bowman. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Council Bill 015 becomes resolution, excuse me, 014 becomes resolution R010. Council Bill 015.
A resolution approving All Seasons Productions LLC as the new lease operator of the city owns North Lake Shooting Range and authorizing the city administrator to execute the attached lease agreement with All Seasons Productions LLC.
Good evening, Mr. Deal.
Good evening, Mayor, members of the board. As stated in the memo that you have, staff received two RFPs for the lease operations of the Trap and Skeet Shooting Range. Both of the applicants met the minimum requirements, but the applicant that staff is recommending went above and beyond the RFP, presented with very good and detailed business plan. Staff is recommending All Seasons Productions LLC as the new lease operator of the Trap and Skeet Range. Mr. Brandon Plunkett is the owner, and he is also the owner of Sporting Supply here in Harrisonville. Looking at the bullet points on the memo, staff highlighted the $300 rent and 10% of profit sales was agreed to. The applicant has proposed to install new clay throwers with an estimated investment of $40,000. Actually, it's going to be a bit more than that. The applicant is proposing a new activity that is well known among trap and skeet participants, and that is called sporting clays. This activity includes 9 to 10 shooting stations that are laid out over a natural terrain. This is similar to the action that is already going on out there with the 5-stand at the range, but it's going to be expanded. The course will be set up with the recommended safety guidelines. The addition also of an archery range was included for shooting competitions, future expansion of a concession area, and the insurance provided by the applicant would cover all of the city requirements, including all equipment activities at the range. And last but not least, Mr. Plunkett has a similar business in Harrisonville that is successful, and this will enhance the abilities to market at the Trap and Skeet Range and have readily available inventory. In closing, All Seasons Production LLC is recommended by staff and unanimously by the Parks and Recreation Board. And the lease agreement has been reviewed by the city attorney's office and approved. And I will be happy to answer any questions. And also, Mr. Plunkett is here this evening as well. And appreciate him coming and his support. And I'll answer any questions you may have.
Maybe I missed it, but what's the length of the lease?
The lease is, in the lease agreement, is for 5 years for the first initial and then renewable for another 5 years.
Thank you.
I, for one, am excited that it's someone local, and like you say, it helps enhance the advertisement of it. I mean, it's another good draw, and I think it goes along with the business they have now. I mean, it's a good fit, so excited it happened so quick.
You said there is going to be an archery area?
Yes.
And am I wrong, did the high school just start an archery program, or somebody start an archery program that they might be able to
Give me sure to use, your mic.
Use that facility? Did somebody just
I honestly, I don't know what area started our true program.
I think.
Somebody did.
I think you, the, we had a, I think that there was a.
I bought my kid one for Christmas.
I think the school did do something because they have to get permission from the police department to do that because there is an ordinance for.
So that might be.
Discharging, that's considered discharging a firearm, so. Yeah, they're, I know they did it when I was in school, we had archery, so I mean, it's.
Can we not arrange a park?
There was one time.
On that, I think we just voted on that last year.
The archery range, we did have an archery range at the park, but the paintball.
It's paintball now.
Took that.
Yeah.
And there was an archery range out on the 291. I don't know whether it's still around or what. The guy has a business out there.
Well, competition archery is, I know, very popular, so this will be another nice draw.
Good.
Good.
Well, I would entertain a motion.
Move, we approve.
Second.
I have a motion from Alderman Coburn and a second from Alderman Milner. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Council Bill 015 becomes Resolution R011.
Thank you.
Thank you. Council Bill 016.
An ordinance to amend Chapter 700, Section 700.230 of the Utilities Ordinance regarding the use of well water in the city of Harrisonville, Missouri.
Good evening, Mayor and Board. This is Director DeLuca's ordinance proposal, so I'm going to talk about it as best I can. But I was just reading the ordinance itself, and I don't think it says what he intended to.
Well, it's the first reading, so we can.
But basically what it's. Yeah. Currently it says, on parcels of land located outside of Harrisonville's water service area and used for industrial production purposes, and that's all it says. What I think it should say is probably to allow industries to use well water on parcels of land outside of Harrisonville's water service area and used for industrial purposes only. Basically what it was intended to do, companies that use water for cooling, they would be allowed to use surface water, well water, and pull that in and use it for non-potable purposes. They wouldn't be drinking water, but it would be used to things like their cooling and things like that. That was the purpose of the ordinance. So after talking to Kim, that would be what I would suggest that it got changed to be at the very beginning to allow industries to use well water, and then at the very end, only on top of that ordinance.
I think, are we allowing them to drill for a while?
Yes. But we don't have ordinance against drilling.
Okay.
So how does this, I mean, I had some questions on this when I was reading it. My assumption is they're in a different water district than ours in these areas that would be, you know, drilling or else, of course, we'd be adding. Is there water currently available from other districts in these areas? And by doing this, are we intruding on another water district's right to sell that water? I guess.
Water districts, most water districts do not have anything that prohibits people from drilling wells. I know currently District 4 does not have anything against that. Huh?
And the county does. County water, if you're within 10 or 15 miles of their line, you have, they will condemn your well and make you hook onto their line.
That I'm not aware of.
Yeah.
But my guess is theirs would be tied to potable water, not tied to an industrial use. And I'm guessing it was a health concern is why.
Question.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
I know you probably don't know, but do you know whether this was reviewed by the city attorney?
I had no idea. Again, I didn't write this.
Yeah, I can understand.
I'm open to discussion, and my recommendation tonight is we have first reading so we can get some answers, few of these,
right.
Get the wording changed. It's something that Rick was ill and unable to be here, so you know, it's his ordinance to that, you know, he had the information, and so I think having some further questions for him to clarify. I mean, I'm open to continue this discussion. I just wanted to say let's.
I don't know if it's appropriate, but I think Mr. Butler had something to.
Yeah, it's not so much the water that you're using, it's where that water goes and the infiltration into your ponds and your city water around it. That's a killer. Because if it's for industrial purposes, you have no idea what's next in that water.
These things don't get discharged out into the public. Most of these things are contained, they're treated, and then they're sent into the city sewer system. DNR would have a heyday if people were releasing these out into the ground. So...
I would mind seeing some further, you know, I mean, it's a good point. I like to see what is it that they do. I mean, you know, especially if it's going into a city sewer. Now, I don't know if it's an area where we don't have water. I assume we don't have sewer in that same area at this point, or, I mean...
It could gravity into us for sewer, but it is outside of the water district.
I have a problem with the fact that we're circumventing another water district's ability to sell water. I mean, I don't think I would like that if they were doing it to Harrisonville, and I don't think that that water district would like that too much, that we're granting that to somebody coming in there, because we're
You might be surprised, because usually when you have something like this, the water demand is so high, the water districts will have a real hard time supplying that much water. And we're finding this out currently dealing with the Warner property. District 4 has right for part of it. They don't have anywhere near the amount of water needed for most industry.
Have they expressed any interest in wanting to, I mean, I don't know what it would take for them to upgrade their system. Of course, you would be talking about some type of fee and all that. I mean, I understand his point of, you know, if there's a water district in place that would like to have the sales, but again, if it's not cost effective,
If you ask a water district, and I know this for a fact from District 4, they are in place to sell water to residents. And they'll tell you that. Anybody can call them. They serve industry and retail only because they have to because of territory. They don't want to do fire flow. They want to just sell potable water and nothing else. So I don't know that it's an issue with the water districts. I know it's not with District 4 for sure.
Well, and then, like I said, I don't know for a fact. The things I would take from this be, one, to check on what Alderman Dixon said about the county. Does the county have something like that in place?
Okay.
That's a good idea.
Two, what are they doing with the water after it's pumped into the place? A little more explanation on that. And then what was the other?
If it had been a reviewed by the attorney.
Correct.
And let's see.
And then the additional wording needed to kind of, the language be defined to be very specific is what we're doing. Because I think he said something about drilling, which we don't have an issue with anyway.
Again, whether they discharge water from a well mm-hmm. or from a city or district mm-hmm. service, you have the same issue whether it's a well water or city water. So I don't know if that's a real issue, at least as far as this is concerned.
Okay.
Yeah, but the infiltration is large.
Again, that's whether it's city or well water.
All right. Well, we will have the second reading at our next meeting, and we'll have those answers brought back.
Okay. Move on. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. All right. Back to the page here. We are Alderman Committee Reports already. Alderman Goldman.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I had the privilege, along with about 100 other folks from Harrisonville, to attend the clock tower restoration dedication ceremony on Saturday morning, and how impressive it was. The weather was incredible. The crowd was very nice turnout, and hearing the history of that clock tower was just thrilling to me. I talked with the gentleman who did the video and who launched the drone, who also took video of both the courtroom as well as the surrounding area on the courthouse. And he had indicated to me, his name is Ken Smithers, he had indicated to me that he was going to take several hours of video and was going to submit that to PBS and ask them if they would do a documentary on our courthouse and on our square and on our clock tower. And as I think about that, in conjunction with the discussion that we've had this evening about revitalizing the square, how exciting that is to be able to have the possibility of a PBS documentary come and film our square as it's coming back to life, not as it's boarded up and no longer significant, but as it's coming back to life. So I am just really, really energized by that. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Alderman Dahl?
I had the privilege of attending as well, and it was a nice event. So I learned a lot about all the parts were original, so that was pretty awesome too, that you were able to bring the exact parts back and utilize them, so that was pretty cool. Other than that, thank you.
Alderman Coburn?
It was a great event.
Alderman Miller?
I have nothing, thanks.
Alderman Dickerson?
I echo the same thing. It was very educational, and it was a nice turnout for everyone there. Very historic piece of equipment.
Alderman Long?
I'm just excited to hear it again. I lived down the road from it, grew up listening to it, so pretty excited to hear it.
Alderman Stoll?
No report.
Alderman Stafford?
Just congratulations to Mr. Plunkett on the lease for the shooting range. I'm sure we'll be glad to have it back open, so thanks.
Well, I would like to add one more thing. I thought it was nice that we all got on the same page about the score.
Absolutely.
I think that was a great accomplishment for this board tonight.
Mr. Tholen? Your day in the spotlight, your moment in the spotlight.
Well, since it's a short meeting, I'll try not to make it a day in the spotlight.
I appreciate that.
A reminder that city offices are closed on Monday, February 15th, in recognition of President's Day holiday. Wanted to thank the members of the board for their participation with the recruitment advisor. Their firm is now working on putting together a draft of the profile. We'll be getting that back to us this week. If things proceed according to plan, we may be calling on the board for a brief special meeting next week to look at and give a final approval to that so that the recruitment can proceed.
Very good.
Exciting.
Well, and I obviously had the privilege of joining my partners up there in the square for the historic clock restoration presentation. It was very neat. The original faces to the clock were all wooden, and they had some pieces of that there, and I guess now they've replaced it with aluminum, so it should last, quote-unquote, forever. The clock itself, the mechanism, the main mechanism, if you get online, Ken Smithers has a Facebook page, like you said, and you can see the pictures. But the actual mechanism is just beautiful. I mean, I can't believe the work they did to it. So they're getting it dialed in still. They said it may be off a little. We're all spoiled by the age of the cell phone where you have exact time. When we were growing up and the clock chime, we probably never noticed it might have been off a little bit here or there. But it is chiming again. David Atkinson said he would like them to crank it up full bore so everybody can hear it across the town. But they're not quite there yet. Did learn that Alderman Dickerson's, was it your grandfather?
Great-grandfather.
Great-grandfather helped get the actual bell.
And the
clock up in there, so that was quite interesting to hear a little bit about how they got that up there. A lot of history in that clock. It's something that we almost lost, and it's kind of like the square. We can't afford to lose it. We need to keep it, and I think this board did a fabulous job tonight coming together and finding common ground on what we can do for that.
Can I ask
you
a question?
Yes, sir. Absolutely.
I heard that they had some guy has to go up there every 8 days and pull that. Is that it?
Mm-hmm. Well, that's what it was.
That was when it was
they
original.
Cranked it.
Yeah, that was a crank.
And they've got the original crank that they used to do.
It's actually an electric motor now. It was converted. Yeah, it's converted to electric.
It isn't electric.
Yes, no, there's an electric motor out there.
The weights come down and hit a switch, and then it sends it back up.
Yeah.
And then it stops, and then as the weight comes down,
I'll show you a picture.
And then it'll hit that, and then it turns the motor on and runs it back up.
And of course, you want Larry Boucher, who's in charge of it, told me they converted it back to the original workings.
Well, it is, but
there's still an electric motor that takes the place of the crank.
Almost. Yeah. Almost ready.
Yep, as close as you can get. So.
Were you going to volunteer for that job?
Every 8 days.
There's a lot of stairs.
No, it's every 8 days, so you get 7 days off.
Yeah.
Anyway, well, and I hope everyone else enjoyed the brief warm weather we had. I think we all earned that, so we'll hope to have some more of that, and we'll need to scrape our streets.
I do not see the media with us tonight, and we do not have an executive session, so I will...
Move adjourned.
Second.
A motion from Alderman Coburn and a second from Alderman Dickerson. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? We are adjourned. Thank you.